It's great to be back in the winner's circle, especially in GAP, which I haven't participated in for a couple years. I'm thrilled. This is my GAP is my home, and you know, it's pretty special to be able to claim a victory, you know, back in the senior division.
The 2014 senior amateur champion returned to his throne Tuesday at Country Club of Scranton. Chip Lutz carded a 1-under par 71 to prevail in the tournament's 51st edition by a record 6 strokes. Two-time defending senior amateur champion Chris Feger Sr. of Philadelphia Publix earned runner-up honors. It marked Lutz's first individual GAP imprint, if you will, since 2018, when he secured a 9th straight Senior Player of the Year award.
I had to reflect on where I've been, where I'm going. I still really haven't solved that question completely, but it sure is good to be back, you know, and win another one. I guess this might give me a little more incentive to stay with it, perhaps. My wife keeps saying that I should really keep going, as long as I'm healthy, to keep playing.
Lutz's golf game is clearly in good health. The LedgeRock member never trailed in the event's final round. A 2-putt birdie on the par 5, 535-yard 14th hole, his 4th red figure of the day, all but reassured a foregone conclusion.
I hit that first one a little too strong and got up above the pin, and I thought it was really kind of a backstop, but it stopped on that downslope, and that really was a difficult putt that I converted, and I think that was really key, you know, to feeling the will to continue on and stay with my game and stay with my plan.
A Super Senior Trophy wasn't part of Gregory Osborne's plan Tuesday. The Overlook Golf Course member trailed 18-hole leader Mike Osick of Hershey's Mill by 3 strokes entering the final round.
I really had no expectations. This is the first time I played the golf course yesterday, and I made a bogey the first 2 holes and almost double bogey the first hole, and it was purely because I've never played here, and I realized very quickly how difficult the greens are.
The realization of steady golf resulted in Osborne's first GAP triumph. He carded an even par 72 to edge Sandy Run's Duke Delcher and 5 Pond's Brian Rothes by a stroke.
I made 3 birdies and 3 bogeys, and the bogeys could have been pars. I mean, they didn't have to be, but I really never hit it out of play. I mean, I was in play all day. GAP is a phenomenal organization. I mean, what they do for golf is incredible. So I'm thrilled to be a part of it.
Signing off from Scranton, for GAP TV, Tony Regina.